Hey guys, it's Marcia from SassyCritic.com. How you doing? I'm back. I just came back to do a quick video. I wanted to do a review on a hair product that I recently purchased. It's by Alikay Naturals. I got this, they had a really good Black Friday sale going on. I've seen this for sale in stores. I've seen other people, you know, who say they use it and they really like it. I had just never tried it before. So I did purchase it with my own money, and I am going to demonstrate myself putting it in my hair, and then I'm going to come back with my results when my hair is dry. So stay tuned. Okay, so the products that I bought from Alikay Naturals, there were two of them. One is the Lemongrass Leave-in Conditioner. And the other is the Creme Brulee Curling Delight. Hope you can see that okay. So the Lemongrass Leave-in Conditioner smells really, really good. If you like that lemongrass smell, you would really like this. It is a spray bottle, which I thought was interesting. So I'm going to put that in. Well, first I have a detangler that I use by Shea Moisture. It's the Raw Shea Butter Extra Moisture Detangler. This one by Shea Moisture. I really like this detangler. So what I'm going to do is I just washed my hair, shampoo and conditioned it. So what I'm going to do is split it into two real quick. I have to stand back. I don't know. And I'm going to put maybe about a quarter size in each section. Not that much. And rub it in. Smooth it through, really get those ends. Do the same on the other side. This stuff is really good. It really helps detangle my hair easily because my hair gets, I have fine hair, so it's not extremely thick. It's not very thick at all, but it tangles very easily. And then I'm going to take my shower comb and detangle each section. Starting at the ends and working my way up to the roots. Get that done. Do the same thing on this side. And okay, I'm back. I just detangled my hair using the Shea Moisture Extra Moisture Detangler. And one more step. It is winter. It's probably like 32 degrees outside or something like that. In the winter, I pack on the moisture a little bit more. So before I put the Alikay Naturals products in, I'm going to put in some argan oil into my hair. This is the one that I use. It's the Pura Dior Argan Oil. I love this stuff. I did a review for this product on my blog, sassycritic.com. I will put a link to it up here. Where is it up here? I'm not sure, but it's going to be in one of these corners, okay? Check out that review. It comes in a pump. So I'm going to pump. A little goes a long way with this stuff. So I'm just going to put a little bit in my hand, about that much. It's running all down. And just smooth it through. A little bit more on this side. A little goes a long way, I find, with argan oil, so my hair comes out so gross to me. It feels gross. Okay. Anyway. Now for the leave-in conditioner. Make sure I close it properly. Now, it is a spray. This is not my first time using it. As you can see, my hair is on it, but so I'm gonna spray some in my I don't like the whole spray thing. Okay, my hand was wet. I couldn't grip the bottle right. But if you can if you can see, I don't know if there's something wrong with my bottle or what, but the spray is not very effective. So I just open it up and put some from the tube into my hand. I think I just dropped some. Okay. And the instructions say to spray it onto your wet hair. Be sure to saturate each strand of hair to ensure proper coverage. Style as usual. Can also be used as a daily moisturizing spray. Simply spray onto hair and then style as usual. This ain't gonna be a styling product for me. So, do the same kind of thing as I did with the oil. I'm gonna rake it through my hair. I need a little bit more. So I'm going to take it from the tube again. It's a little watery. It smells really good though. Okay, I'm going to rake it in. I'm going to get some for the other section. I am making a straight mess on the floor. Just dripping this stuff all over my floor. Let me get some more. I personally think that this should come in, not with a spray. It should come with a spout that you can just squeeze it out instead. But like I said, I don't know if there's just something wrong with my spray bottle that I got. Maybe I got a bad one because it's not spraying out very well. Okay, so got that in there. Yeah. Let's move on, shall we? To the Creme Brulee Curling Delight. It says it contains natural and organic ingredients. Okay, it says apply after shampooing and leave the hair wet. Section hair into 4 to 6 sections. Take a small amount of Creme Brulee and apply to hair row by raking the product through hair from root to tip. Start with applying product to sections in the back, then move to the front sections. After applying product to entire head, shake hair side to side, back and forward to remove excess water and product. And hopefully not give myself whiplash, okay? Spray on lemongrass leave-in conditioner generously over hair. What? So this ain't put the leave-in conditioner after, anyway. Either let the hair air dry or sit underneath a dryer or use a diffuser. You shouldn't need to reapply product to hair until next wash day. Results may vary. They say, they give a hair tip on here, says for best results, apply in the shower immediately after shampooing. Using clips to put hair in sections help to style quicker. Okay. We're not doing that today. So, I'm going to, here it is, it's like a, wait, just a little piece of hair in there. I hate when that happens. I missed that last time. Okay, so it's yellow, like the other one. It's a jelly-like consistency. So let's see here. I'm not going to section my hair anymore because my hair really isn't that thick, as you can see. So I just stick with 2 sections, make my life easier. I'm gonna take this much . It's like jelly. The smell, this one does not have a lemon scent. I honestly can't tell you what it smells like. I mean, it's not bad, it's nice, but I don't know what it smells like. It's a pleasant smell. As I'm putting it in, I'm also gonna, my tiptoes are a little short, scrunch the ends a bit. Take about the same amount and put on the other section. And what I like to do, because I don't want to have that part down the middle of the back of my head, So I just use my fingers and kind of comb the hair together in the back. And then I like to put a little bit over to the side in the front, over to my left side. And what I'm gonna do is put a little bit more on top. Okay. Put a little bit more and run it through all of the hair. And I'm gonna scrunch, just going like this in an upward motion. You can probably hear my dog barking. The kids, I'm playing with him. And he's barking. Hope it's not too distracting. Okay. All right, so this is basically how I do my hair daily, my wash and goes. Regardless of what product I'm using, I pretty much follow those same steps. I put in my detangler, I use a leave-in conditioner, put in the styling product, and then, oh, one more thing. I usually put in a scrunch in a little bit of gel on my ends just because my ends tend to frizz up a little bit when they rub on my clothing. So let me get the gel. I'll be right back. Okay, so this is the gel I like to use. It's the Camille Rose Curl Maker Gel. This is some good stuff, y'all. It does dry crunchy, it does. But once you scrunch that out, the hair looks so nice. But I don't use a lot. Main reason is because this thing costs $22 and I'm not trying to keep buying that for $22. So this is actually, I bought this maybe a little over a year ago. So this is how much I have left. Because I use just a little bit at a time. So what I'm going to do is put the hair on the side. This is literally how much I use. If I can squeak it out. Just like that. That's it. Okay. That's it. Rub it. And then I lightly like graze my hair. Just from the midpoint to the ends, graze it, and then I scrunch the ends. And I also have to remember to do the, because my hair is layered, so I have to remember to do the shorter parts in the front, too. That's that, and I don't diffuse my hair. Every time I try doing that, it's been a big frizzy disaster. I don't know if I'm doing something wrong. I don't think so, but it just has not worked for me. I just air dry my hair. One thing I do to help the drying process go by faster is I will plop with a cotton t-shirt, or I have these flour sack towels that I got from Target. They're just cotton, big cotton squares, and I'll plop with that. And what plopping is putting your hair into this cotton t-shirt or this flour sack towel and tying it up, and that helps get rid of the excess moisture, and it helps kind of set the curls because this whole your hair is like on top of your head, and so it's kind of setting the curls. So when you take it off, your curls are a little more defined. So I'll probably do that for about 15 minutes, then take it down, and then let it air dry the rest of the way. So I will come back when it's all dry, which will be in a couple hours. Okay, so I'll see you later. Okay guys, I am back. It has been about an hour and a half. My hair is pretty much, I would say 95% dry. There's just a little bit, tiny bit, right in the middle here, that's a tiny bit damp, just a little bit. The rest of my hair is pretty dry. It's dry, yeah. Excuse me. One thing that I do notice with this product is that my hair does tend to dry a little bit faster. It usually takes
about 3 hours for my hair to dry from beginning to end. But with this one, I would say it's an hour and a half, 2 hours to be fully dry. So that's a good thing for me, at least, especially in the winter time. So what I normally do, it is a little bit crunchy. Remember, I did put in the curl maker gel at the end, so it is a little crunchy. So what I always do is put my hair all together. I just twist it around, because just doing this kind of scrunches out the crunch. I just twist it around in my hands. Every once in a while, I might put a little oil in my hand before I do this, but I didn't do that today. Oh, and I did not plop afterwards. I ended up doing some things with my kids, so I didn't plop. I just got to do what I was doing. And then I will do the same thing up here. There's a tiny bit of crunch. And then fluff it out. Like so, do the same thing on this side. Get the crunch out. It's really not that hard. Just a tiny bit. But now, once I do that, it's nice and soft. And if you remember when I read the directions for the creme brulee, it said to flip your hair side to side and back and forth. I don't do that when my hair is wet. To get rid of moisture, that's just not a strategy I use. However, when my hair is dry and when I'm fluffing it out, that is something that I will do just to fluff it out some more. So as you can see, I have fluffed it out some. The curls are they're defined. I don't think I get a whole lot of curl definition with this product, but it is shiny, and I think it looks good. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to flip my head over. Okay, I go upside down and fluff it out a little bit more, and then flip back up. Okay, here I go. Fluff around. And flip back up and see, I have a little bit more volume, and since my hair is fine, I always like to get as much volume as I possibly can. So this is what I would do. Sometimes I stick my hand in, pull out just a little bit to kind of give a little bit of volume at the root also. Do that all around. Okay, and so see, voila, I think it looks a lot better. A little more fluffy, a little more volume. I think this did not curl up as much as I would like it to. But this is like one big lock, so I'm going to separate them. It also helps with achieving a little more volume. Separate those curls that stick together. Fluff it out. I think that's good. One thing that I would say is a negative with these products is that, I don't know, I'd have to look at the rest of their line. Sorry, I noticed hair sticking out. I have to look at the rest of their line of products. I don't know if yellow is like the signature color, for Alikay Naturals, but, for a company that touts to be using natural products and things, I think that's great. I prefer that. It doesn't have any parabens and silicones and all that kind of stuff in it. Let me get the bottle and I'll see exactly what it has in it in just a second. Okay, I have here the lemongrass leave-in conditioner. So let me just skim through the ingredients so you know what's in here. Excuse me, water is the first ingredient, so that's good. Aloe vera, coconut derived sterile alcohol. Sterile alcohol is a fatty alcohol, so it's not bad. And it's coconut derived. I guess they got it from coconuts. Okay. Silk amino acids, which is natural protein. So that is something to take into consideration, that this does have proteins in it. So if your hair does not get along with proteins, or you know, you have too much protein, this is not the product for you, you know, because too much protein can cause hair to be like straw-like and hard, and it's not cute. vegetable glycerin, excuse me, sweet almond oil, wheat germ oil, lemongrass oil extract, natural detangling agent, food grade preservative, fragrance, color yellow number 5, and a botanical blend. And the creme brulee ingredients are, it says key ingredients. The key ingredients are the aloe vera gel, agave stem nectar, argan oil, coconut oil, sweet almond oil, rosemary leaf extract, fragrance color, which is yellow number 5, and a botanical blend. So again, they don't have silicones, parabens, sulfates, those kinds of things that are typically not very good for naturally curly hair. The only downside I would say to this is, and it's probably really not that big of a deal, is, I don't know, something about the color. Adding that yellow color is just like, what for? I don't know. I don't know what color it would have been without it, but I feel like it's not necessary. If it didn't come naturally from one of the ingredients, I don't see the purpose of putting in the yellow. But then again, I don't know. I'm sure they have their own reasons for doing it. Maybe yellow is their signature color. I don't know. Probably is not my business. But that's the only thing I could say that I wish wasn't in there, because most of the products that I use, hair products that I use, I don't ever really notice a color added in most of them, unless they're not listing it. But I think most of the products I use are either white or like a clear color anyway. So I think they really could have left it out. It's not very necessary. But overall, I do like the results of the products. I mean, I think it looks good. Now, this is just a wash and go. My hair is like a, if you're into curl typing, my hair is 3B, 3C, a mixture of 3B and 3C curl patterns. I don't know. Well, let me know what you think down below in the comments. If you like this video, please hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe to my channel, please, and share this with your friends or anybody who might have been wondering about these products. And let me know if you've tried these products in the comments and what your experience has been. I'd also like you guys to comment on suggestions for future videos. Let me know what you'd like to see. Don't forget to also check out my blog, sassycritic.com, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care and be safe. Bye-bye.